Welcome to Rock Creek Campus Biology Laboratories. This is the safety spiel. We'd like to familiarize you with some rules and procedures designed to ensure safety in the lab. We ask that you sign a safety sheet agreeing to follow these instructions before taking part in lab exercises. This sheet summarizes the information you are receiving now. Please be sure to read it over.
Here are some guidelines on emergencies. In the event of an emergency, first contact the nearest authority. In the back of the lab, we have equipment to deal with emergencies. Among this equipment is the first aid kit. Let us know if anything is low in the first aid kit so we can replenish it. We also have fire equipment, including a fire blanket and a fire extinguisher. In the event of a fire, your responsibility is simply to get out of the building and notify others as you leave. However, if a fellow student were on fire, it would be common courtesy to throw a fire blanket on them.
When you evacuate the building, go to the nearest safe assembly area for this building. The first is on the west side of the building. Do not stand in the parking lot as a fire truck may be traveling through it. The second is on the end of the parking lot near Building 9, where the safe assembly sign is located. These areas may change, so pay attention to directions from the instructor.
When you go to the safe assembly area, it is important that you stay there until you are told it is safe to go back into the building. Just because the fire alarm has stopped sounding doesn't mean you can go back in. You need to be told specifically that it is safe.
Our system has a verbal component that will tell you whether the alarm is for a fire or a lockdown. In the case of a lockdown drill, you will be asked to duck under your desk and stay until the all clear sounds. If it is a real event, you will be asked to close the locked doors and quickly go into the biology prep room where the doors are all locked and there are no windows. You will stay there until it is safe to come out.
If you decide to leave campus during an evacuation, please be sure to notify your instructor first. We also have a safety shower and an eyewash station. You would use these in the event of being splashed by a caustic or burning chemical such as an acid or a base, either on your clothes or in your eyes. Pulling down on the triangle activates the safety shower. You'll get deluged with water, and when you're done, push up on the triangle to turn off the water. Either using the hand lever or the foot pedal can activate the eyewash station, but it needs to be shut off with your hand lever when you are through. If you need to rinse chemicals out of your eyes, it is important to keep your eyes in the flow of water for a full 15 minutes in order to protect them properly. Just be aware that 15 minutes is going to seem like a much longer time than it is. In the event of an earthquake, the proper procedure is to get under your desk and stay there until everything stops moving. Then evacuate the building and go to a safe assembly area. And, once again, wait until you are told it is safe to come back into the building. The other piece of emergency equipment is the telephone. In the event of an emergency, the number you should call is 4444. That is the PCC Public Safety Emergency Number. They can dispatch both public safety officers who are already on campus, as well as 911 personnel.
There are rules and procedures to protect you when you are in the lab. Some are very simple. For instance, there is no eating or drinking in the lab under any conditions ever. Also, no children are allowed in the lab. It is important to wear proper attire in the lab.
Baggy clothing and loose hair can catch fire and cause spills. Hats and bare midriffs are not acceptable in the laboratory. And shoes, not sandals, must be worn at all times.
Be sure to report minor spills and minor injuries to your instructor or prep room staff immediately so that it can be taken care of properly. Certain spills require special procedures for cleanup. Beyond this, we have some more technical equipment to protect you when you work in the lab. One of these is the fume hood. Proper operation requires that the hood be turned on, the sash be lowered, and that your head be outside the sash. Chemicals that you will use during your experiments are distributed to you in reagent bottles, which have hazard code labels on the front of the bottle. A hazard code label has a diamond with four smaller colored diamonds in it: blue, red, yellow, and white. Each colored diamond has a number in it, which tells the hazard associated with that chemical. The blue diamond refers to the health hazard of the chemical. The red diamond refers to the flammability hazard, and the yellow diamond refers to the reactivity of the chemical. The numbers range from 0 to 4. 0 is the least hazardous, and 4 is the most. The white diamond at the bottom has a letter in it that refers to suggested personal protective equipment to be used while handling that chemical. These codes are explained on a poster found in every lab. Safety goggles can also be found in each lab. Additional information about chemicals can be obtained from your instructor or from prep room personnel.
Accidents can be prevented by generally being aware of what is happening around you.
Cubby holes and shelves are provided to store stuff you do not need while in the lab, such as backpacks, coats, and purses.
Use paper towels and disinfectant provided to clean your benches before and after every use. The rooms are set up for multiple classes each week, so make sure that the supplies you are using are designated for use by your class. Label all your test tubes and flasks with the identity of the chemical in them to help you keep track of your work as well as to aid in proper disposal. It is important to avoid cross-contamination of chemicals. To do that, make sure you check the labels on the chemical bottles and label on the pipettes provided to be sure that they match. It is also important to know which things are disposable and which things are not. Items that are commonly mistaken as disposable are pipette pumps. Please do not throw these away. The only glassware that is disposable are Pasteur pipettes. These can be disposed of in the glass disposal box.
Do not throw pipette bulbs in the trash or glass waste.
Other pipettes are not disposable and should be washed. It is the student's responsibility to clean up after themselves. This means returning all equipment and reagents to wherever you got them, the counter or the carts. Dirty glassware should be rinsed out and placed in the dish drainer or upside down on paper towels in some orderly manner. Please do not put dirty test tubes back with the clean test tubes.
Microscopes are perhaps the fundamental tool of biology. We are lucky to have very good student scopes available and need your help in caring for them. Microscopes are expensive and fragile. When taking a scope out of the cabinet, grasp it by the arm. When moving one, support it with two hands, one on the arm and one under the base.
Before putting the scope away, be sure to clean the lenses as directed by your instructor. Lower the stage, secure the cord neatly, and if available, cover the scope with a dust cover.
Also, be sure the slide is removed and the low objective is in position.
Make sure to put the microscope in the cabinet with the arm facing outward from the cabinet.
You will also need to clean the lenses on occasion. The oculars or eyepieces get smeared with skin oil and makeup.
Immersion oil is used with high power objective and must be cleaned off afterwards. If oil is allowed to dry on an objective, it becomes difficult to clean or to see through. Both type of lenses are cleaned only with liquid lens cleaner and lens paper.
It is very important to use only designated lens paper as other paper can cause scratches. Put cleaner on the paper and dab it on the soiled lens. Gently wipe the cleaner off the lens with the clean paper. Repeat this a few times, especially for the oil objective. Remember that oil sometimes gets on the other objectives as well. Be sure to check all objectives for cleanliness. If oil is allowed to dry on an objective, it becomes difficult to clean or to see through.
Oil slides can be cleaned with Kim wipes or paper towels, but not lenses.
When you take out your scope, check it over to see if it's clean and has no loose parts. If the scope you use is found in poor condition, report this to your instructor. These methods will ensure the safety of the scopes and give the best performance.
The biology labs generate several distinct waste streams, and disposal gets complicated. Disposal containers in the lab include a glass disposal box, a sharps container, a recycling bin, and a regular trash barrel. Each vessel has a sign on the wall next to it stating what can and cannot be put into it. Additionally, there's a master sign entitled "How to Dispose of Stuff." These signs should lead you down the right path. An important point is that anything sharp needs to be disposed of in a container designed to protect people taking out the trash. This is either the glass disposal box or the sharps container. The difference is that the sharps container is for biohazard waste. That is waste that is potentially alive and infectious, such as bacteria cultures and blood. Occasionally, you will use chemicals that need to be disposed of as hazardous waste. Your instructor will direct you to containers provided for collection of these chemicals. Please do not dump chemicals down the drain until you know it's safe to do so.
The Americans with Disabilities Act provides that disabilities need not be disclosed, but that confidential requests can be made for their accommodations. Please contact your instructor or prep room staff for more information. The prep room staff hopes that your lab experience will be safe, educational, and entertaining.
The microbiology course entails some advanced waste disposal. In micro, you will be dealing with bacteria nearly every session. Bench disinfecting is therefore extra important for both your safety and experimental success. When you're finished with your cultures, it's important that they be disposed of properly. The biohazard bucket is used for bugs in plastic petri dishes. Contaminated disposable plastic implements should also be put in the biohazard bucket. The contents of these buckets are sterilized in the autoclave, so it is necessary that only items contaminated with living biological materials be placed in them. Never put glass in the biohazard bucket.
Bacteria and glass tubes are placed in wire baskets for autoclaving.
Bacterial samples are taken away after nearly every class session and sterilized soon after.
Cultures you want to save go in the refrigerator, labeled for your lab section.
Unlabeled cultures left on the benches or counters are liable to be lost.
Do not leave loops resting in back incinerators.